Hi, I'm Matt, and this is the Shirtless Apprentice. This week on the Shirtless Apprentice, we're gonna cover the basics of using a sungun. There's two different types of sunguns predominantly. There's incandescent sunguns that run off of light bulbs, and there's LED sunguns that use light emitting diodes. And there's pluses and minuses to using each one. And we're gonna go over those. Right now, I'm gonna show you how to mount a sungun. So let's go see how that's done. There's two main ways that sunguns mount. There's a stud mount and a shoe mount. This sungun I have here, I have a shoe mount that screws into the stud mount. And all you're gonna do with that shoe mount is you're just gonna slide it right into the shoe of your camera. And now you're just gonna tighten the adjustment so the sungun doesn't move. And you have it mounted. The next thing you're gonna do is take the power cable. And there's many different types of mounts. This is a D-mount cable. And we're gonna just plug it into the mount on the back. And now your light will have power. I have the diffusion mounted on the light here. Sometimes it's a little too strong. So what I like to do then, if you can see this, I like to take a little piece of gaff tape and put it right into the center of the light. The reason why I do that is it covers the hot spot in the middle of the light, kind of takes the edge off. It's a good in-between between using diffusion like this and using no diffusion. The next step that you would do is you would power your light up and you would white balance. And we're gonna give you some examples of what the light looks like when properly white balanced, and we're gonna compare the LED and the incandescent light. And as you can see, that's the incandescent light. And it's very important that you white balance to your light, which we're gonna do right now. Hopefully you'll see some type of a difference. Just gonna use a piece of paper, make a little white balance. And that should do it. So that's an incandescent light. If you can see, it has a good amount of throw, meaning that I can be a reasonable distance away from the camera and still be properly lit. The color temperature makes me look nice and warm. But it's gonna burn a lot of battery. Now we're gonna show you what an LED light looks like. And this is an LED sungun. As you can see, the color's quite a bit different. The skin tones look quite a bit different. It's a little blue-green compared to the orange and yellow of the other light. So now we're gonna re-white balance for you so you can see a difference. And there you have it. So it still might look a little blue-green, the throw isn't quite as strong, but that's why they give you filters for LED lights, and we're gonna see what one of those looks like right now. Warms things up a little bit, but in my opinion, still doesn't look quite right, and you can re-white balance again. I prefer the incandescent lights to the LED. I feel they have a little bit more throw, but they eat quite a bit more battery. I would suggest instead of going with the LED light, bring an extra couple of batteries with you. In a pinch though, the LED light could save you. So those are the basics of why you would need and how you would use a sungun. Next week on The Shirtless Apprentice, I'm gonna cover focusing on continuity. I'm Matt, and this is The Shirtless Apprentice.